I love Pinterest. For those of you that don't know, Pinterest is an app where you can scroll through the feed and be met with countless images. Now, I love all the aesthetic, beautiful, and interesting things that I can find on there. So one day, I was scrolling through my Pinterest feed, and I saw this. Now, this photo had the caption of "Panorama while rolling down a hill," with a heart eyes emoji. Now, I saw this photo, and I was floored. The comment section was saying that it was beautiful, and I decided that I wanted to create something just as beautiful, just as Pinterestable as this one had been. So I took my phone to the hill by our neighborhood park, I put it into panorama mode, and I rolled down the hill. While I did, I had these expectations in my mind of the beautiful photo that I would get as a result. But once I hit the bottom of the hill, and I checked my phone, what I got wasn't this beautiful photo where the sky and the ground work perfectly together. Instead, I got this. And I was so disappointed, because this photo was nowhere near any of the expectations that I'd set or anything that I thought that it would be. But looking back, this photo is one of my favorite photos in my camera roll, because it was so unexpected and because it was so fun. That leads me to the topic of my TED Talk today: why the expectations that we set for ourselves often lead to unhappiness. And only when taking a step back and reframing our expectations are we able to rekindle this happiness again. Now, at the very get-go, having expectations might seem like a really good thing. After all, if you set high expectations for yourself, you push yourself to work harder to achieve greater results. But what we've seen more and more nowadays is that people set themselves to higher and higher expectations. And when they aren't able to meet them, this results in greater levels of unhappiness. Now, I looked into the topic of expectations and their effect on our happiness, and I found that there was actually quite a bit of research that was done on the topic. Experts from University College London did an experiment where they tried to find an equation of happiness. So what they did was they launched a mobile app, which encouraged players to take risky decisions and measured what they expected they would get. What they found was that the players' happiness wasn't related to how well they were doing, but in fact, how well they expected to be doing. And that the greater the divide between their expectations and the results, the greater unhappiness they would get. As a result, the researchers encouraged people to lower their expectations to reasonable standards, but not so far down that they would be miserable as well. Ultimately, they departed with one point of advice that I think is very crucial: that expectations should be used not as a goal, but as a tool, in order to focus on our mindsets and focus on the process. Because when we focus on the process and when we focus on the progress, we're able to find the greatest happiness within ourselves. In the winter of my grade 10 year, I miraculously qualified for Canadian Speech Nationals. Now, going into this competition, my expectations were at an all-time low. I was completely new to speech. Almost no one knew who I was. And so instead of setting expectations based on my results, I set expectations based on positivity and progress, making sure to do my best with every speech in the round. Along the way, I made some amazing friends and learned so much more. And I wasn't nervous during the competition because I wasn't there to try and compete and win. I was there to learn and to grow. So when we were sitting at the awards table at the end of the competition, I'd already accepted at that point that it was okay if I didn't get any awards because I'd done my best and that was all. So when they read the names from 10th to 9th to 8th, I didn't feel too pressured. And yet, the kicker to this story, once I got to the first place, my name was announced as the champion speaker. Now, in that moment, I was flooded with happiness, and I was so thrilled because what I had gotten far preceded any expectations that I'd set for myself in the first place. So the takeaway from this story is that we often can't control what the world throws at us, good or bad. What we can control is our personal effort and our attitude, which makes all of the difference. So I send this message out to each and every one of you. Instead of focusing on the results, focus on your personal attitude, on progress, because maybe it is all about the journey and not the destination. Maybe it is about the friends we make along the way and the things we learn. Because sometimes we can't change how the world works. Maybe I'll have to accept that I'll never be able to take a bendy grass photo, but that's okay. I'd like to conclude then with one last Pinterest comparison. So moon photos on Pinterest are some of the most gorgeous things that I've seen. And yet whenever I try to take photos of the moon, it looks like this, or like this. And yet, one day, I was walking home from this random burger place, and I saw the moon in the sky, and I thought, maybe I'll try one more time to take this photo. So with no expectations, but to just try one more time, I took a snap, and I ended up with something that was not half bad. As a result, focus on the progress and on the process, because once we do, we're able to rekindle our personal happiness and make the most of our situation. Because sometimes the memories that we don't expect are the happiest ones of all. Thank you.